Deadpool and Wolverine 2024. I've just been to see this film. It's kind of intense. I find these multiverse style films overwhelming. I do pick up on the gist of it all. And I suppose today's been an overwhelming day for other reasons, which I may go into in a vlog at some point. But talking about this particular film, it's got a lot happening. It's Certificate 15, strong bloody violence, I think it said at the start, the warning. There's a lot of strong bloody violence. But there's also a huge amount of humour, and it's scattergun humour. There's a lot of humour that some people may not like. Close to the edge, everything goes, and yet delivered in a way that isn't offensive, or at least not that I found offensive. It covers some subjects that are difficult, and there's a lot of death, and there's so many different characters. There's multiple Deadpools, there's more than one Wolverine. Oh gosh, the film starts with a dead Wolverine, and somehow Deadpool finds an alive Wolverine. Yeah, because there's all these multiple universes and layers upon layers of things happening. It makes it very interesting, but difficult as well. Hard to compute. I saw it with a friend, and I'm not sure she liked it as much as me. I don't like a lot of slashery, bloody scenes, but I sort of can tune it out slightly. That's how I cope. I just become more desensitized. When something's repeated a lot, I can just tell myself that it isn't so real. Some things are shocking, but when something keeps happening on screen, I suppose especially when it's a comedy, I think that really helps take the edge off it. If it was like a really serious film, like many action films or certainly horror films, when there's gory scenes, I think it has a larger impact on me psychologically. But when it's a comedy and I can see the joke and I'm laughing, it feels a lot more palatable, I guess. The essence of Deadpool and Wolverine is that Wade Wilson, that's Ryan Reynolds' character, Deadpool, is breaking the fourth wall all of the time. He breaks the fourth wall so much, it's practically a documentary at times, or at least it could be. It's almost like a vlog, a live stream. He's just talking to camera quite a lot and cracking jokes all of the time. And some of the jokes are risque and revolting, and some of them are puns, and he mixes up pronouns. There's a sort of very topical approach, but it isn't what I would call anti-marginal groups. In a way, it's as much taking the mick out of the people who are intolerant, I would say. That's my take on it. Those type of jokes are quite, I found amusing, because he says he's gender blind. Deadpool's take isn't harmful, I would say. So there's this angle. One thing I really liked, there was this battle where one of the characters in it, one of the Deadpools, had the Welsh flag, the Red Dragon. That really tickled me, especially since I guess that's because Ryan Reynolds has he bought Wrexham? I don't know. Wrexham Football Club? I don't follow football. I love those little takes. I'm aware of it. I suppose I listen to Cap Cymru, the Welsh-speaking Capital Radio, contemporary popular music channel. There was a film called Red Notice that I think Ryan Reynolds was in that I haven't yet seen. At some point, I would like to catch up on how Ryan Reynolds became involved in a North Wales football team. So there's that little element as well, fairly fleeting on the screen, but really good. There's continuous battles, and it's full on, as I mentioned, but it's quite a ride, and it's got so much humour all the way through that it kept me entertained. I mean, there's all these different Deadpools from different timelines, different universes. I mean, there's this, all this multiverse stuff. I concentrated enough to understand it, I think, and I'm going to score it 9 out of 10. I think it deserves that. It's just really good fun. As I said, I could stomach the gory bits. Don't like them when they're on screen, but they dissipate in a way that documentaries about wars, all those sort of scenes and horror and some action films, the scenes can stay with me for a lot longer, and it takes a while to get them out of my head. So that's my thoughts. I'd love to know what you think. Thanks for watching. Please like if you like this video. Thanks for subscribing. Hope to see you again soon. Bye for now.